गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन हिस्ट्री इन फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज फ्रेंच सोसाइटी ड्यूरिंग द लेट 18th सेंचुरी, द स्ट्रगल टू सर्वाइव एंड ग्रोइंग मिडिल क्लासेस. इन यस्टरडेज लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद द कॉजेज ऑफ फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन एंड टुडे लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द फ्रेंच सोसाइटी ड्यूरिंग द late 18th century. Children, since 1589 the Bourbon dynasty ruled France and the kings were absolute monarch. Absolute monarch means all the powers in one hand. In 1774 Louis 16th of Bourbon family became the ruler. When did Louis 16th became a ruler? He became a ruler in 1774. Louis XVI, when he became the ruler, he was only 20 years old and married to Austrian princess. When he became the ruler, he found an empty treasury. Because of long years of war and extravagant lifestyle that drained the financial resources of France. Moreover, Louis XVI helped the 13 colonies to gain their independence from Britain, which was their common enemy. Then the French government started taking loans from the money lenders, who used to charge very high rate of interest. So the French government was obliged to spend an increasing percentage of its budget on interest payment alone. To meet his regular expenses such as cost of maintaining an army, court, running government offices or universities, the state was forced to increase the taxes. French society in the 18th century was divided into three states and only the member of third state paid the taxes. Let's see the structure of society. French society in the 18th century. French society in the 18th century was divided into three states. Of them, only the third state paid taxes. The society of the states was part of feudal system that dated back to the Middle Ages. The old regime. Now children, what is the meaning of old regime? The old regime is usually used to describe the society and institutions of France before 1789. That means the institutions or the society before 1789, before the French Revolution, was known as old regime. French society was divided into three main classes known as state. First state constituted the clergy, the second state constituted the nobility, and rest of the population constituted the third state. The first state enjoyed many privileges by birth. For example, they were exempted from paying the taxes, and not only they were exempted paying the taxes, they used to collect the taxes from common people also. The second state consists of nobility. They also enjoyed the same privileges which were enjoyed by the first state, that is the clergy. They were also exempted from paying the taxes. The people, those who are born in first and second state, they had privileges by birth. They don't have to pay taxes, and instead they used to collect the taxes from the common people. Now, the third state, peasants, made up about 90% of the population. Only a small number of them owned the land they cultivated. 60% of land owned by nobles, the church, and the other richer member of the third state. Peasants were obliged to render services to the lord to work in their house and fields, to serve in the army or to participate in the building roads. The rapid expansion of French population from 23 million in 1715 to 28 million in 1789 during the 18th century created a situation in which the grain production could not meet the demand. The price of bread, which was a staple diet of majority, rose rapidly. Most workers were employed as a laborer in a workshop whose owners fixed their wages, but wages did not keep pace with the rise in prices. So the gap between the poor and the rich widened. It became worse when they had a bad weather condition, which usually used to reduce the harvest. This frequently created a subsistence crisis. Subsistence crisis means an extreme situation where the basic means of livelihood was endangered. Subsistence crisis became a part of French society because of rapid increase in population, because of rapid increase in the demand for the food grains, and the wages could not match with the rising prices, and sometimes because of drought or hail, the situation becomes more worse, and this gives birth to the subsistence crisis. Now, the growing of middle classes. Now, the middle class, they want to end the privileges which were enjoyed by the first two states. In the past, the peasants and the workers had participated in revolts against the increasing taxes and food scarcity, but they lacked the means and the program to carry out full-scale measures that would bring about a change in the social and economic orders. This was left to those groups within the third state who had become prosperous and had access to education and new ideas. In the 18th century, a new social group emerged who were known as middle class. They had become rich through the expansion of overseas trades. In addition to merchants and manufacturers, there were lawyers and administrative officials who were educated and believed that no group of a society should be privileged by birth, but their position should depend on merit. The idea based on freedom and equal laws and opportunity for all were put forwarded by the philosophers like John Locke and Jean-Jacques Rousseau. The ideas of different philosophers were discussed intensively in saloons and coffee houses and spread among the people through books and newspapers. These were frequently read aloud in group for the benefit of those who could not read and write. The news that Louis XVI planned to impose further taxes to be able to meet the expenses of the state government angered and the protest against the system of privileges started. That's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.